everybody. I am working on my commission piece today. This is a 15 by 30 inch canvas, and I have already poured the white paint on it. It barely is big enough for this pan, so I knew it would be messy. So I went ahead and did it off camera because you've seen me pour canvases before. They're just so exciting. All right, so I'm going to be doing the reverse stamp technique. Which I have done a lot lately. And I did my sample pour for this a couple days ago with greens, purples, blues. So for my stamper, when I did, well, and also my Carnival of Colors one, that's what I will show you here, is I made my stamper out of these little canvas panels. They come like six to a pack at Michael's, $6 or something. And then I Velcroed it to a cup. So then I had something to hold on to. And then I have this, which I'll just stick a little magnet on the back. All right, but I wanted a round stamper. So I just cut a piece of cardboard out, and you can tell it's a very rough circle. And I'm going to use that. I do need... Oh, now I know why I put, there was a cup sitting here. Now I know why. I need to do a cup of white with silicone. And if you're curious about my how I mix my paint and stuff, I just made a video and it was on yesterday about my paint mixing. Whoops, that was a lot of silicone I just added to here. And what she likes was I had showed her an organic form that had been on a circle. Well, this is obviously not a circle, so it will be quite a bit harder. But I think I will kind of do... like a half, kind of a swirl. So I'm going to put the colors on here. These are, except for two, they are all self-mixed colors, so I really can't tell you what's in them. But various shades of purple. She wanted some more purple. The other one got very blue. To have to set this down. So this is a darker blue with some iridescent in it. This is phthalo green, which is a pure color. I mean, not self-mixed. That. Such a pretty green, too. Ah, this is a mess. This is a green that I mixed up. And the lid does not want to come out. And then this is another softer green that I mixed up. I feel like I need a different purple though. And then this is processed cyan. I guess cayenne would be the pepper. But it's a beautiful blue. And I am going to add a little bit of violet. more of this lighter purple because it already sunk underneath the others. All right, so this is my color palette. Dropped in there. So I am going to, this is the silicone. Okay. Then I am just going to stamp away. Good, I've got some good green to begin with. That's the Velcro you're hearing. And now I'm just adding more, like right here, there's not really any purples, so. All right. I'm going to blow some of this out so that it's more. Well, you know what? First, I'm going to torch it. I'm going to blow it to make it looser looking. Over there, I don't want that falling into stuff. drop of silicone. Just to give it kind of a looser look in places. My straw go. Hope this is the right one. Definitely not moving.
Bald spots.
No, I don't think I do want to pull it out like that. No. Set where it's gonna go, which means I do not need to tilt. I like having the silicone in the white, because then it makes the white pop up, so you end up kind of with hollow cells, I suppose. That's such a glare. I kind of wish it was looser looking. Okay. looks too planned out. Which it was. Someone asked if I ever blew the white into the colors, and that's what I'm doing right here. And I think that side had paint on it. Oh well. I like that a lot better with the looser. Yeah, that's better. See what it looks like up here if I do that too. Not as well. Now let me look at it. I think I'm going to do it down here too. not as much. So much better. Way, way, way better. There's still the color on this side. Trying to kind of step back again. And I really like it. Like these areas are like it'll dry even. Put some more on the edge of this side. And on the top. And then I shall be done. Smooth it out a little. Gosh. And torch one last time because of all of the additions on the top and the bottom. think getting rid of the two ends was a really good decision. And there you have it. Thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you all next time. Bye.